everyone. Welcome to Toy Break episode 231. I'm Aileen.
I'm George.
And we are Toy Break.
231 already? I feel like it was just a minute ago.
It was
like
230.
200. I remember celebrating.
Yeah, party hats and 200. Ponies.
Now it's 231. Woo!
In case you're wondering, Toy Break is your weekly internet show all about news.
Actually, it's our
and
weekly
review.
Internet
no,
show.
No, it's theirs.
Oh,
we do it for
ours.
Them.
We do?
Them right there.
See we're them? Doing this for you. You. I'm talking about you.
So Toy Break is all about the wonderful world of toys, including but not limited to designer vinyl, plush, action figures, collectibles, events, how-tos, interviews, all the goodness and toyness that we can bring you. That's what we try to do. Let's begin, like we always do, by thanking our site sponsors such as Mr. Toast,
3D Retro,
Paysaber,
Grumpy Bert,
Happy Panda Toys,
Black Sheep Button Company,
Button Lab,
Art Attack Toys,
Dragatomy,
Tenacious Toys,
Fuzzy Balls Apparel.
We should just like edit Ben in there every time saying it so he can have the little thing. We should get him doing it on his own, like sitting here by himself.
Okay.
And then edit that in every time.
Okay.
ESC Toy. ESC Toy. More art than toy.
Superpower Collectibles.
DKE Toys.
Thank you so much to all of our site sponsors. Please go to toybreak.com and check out their wares. They have wonderful, wonderful things. We would also like to thank a few people for donations because in the last episode, 230, you said, I wonder if somebody watches from every state in the United
right.
States.
So how many did we get so far?
Well, we have a few. We have Jillian from Canada.
Not in the United States. But thank you for the donation anyway.
Alyssa from Kentucky. Clifton from Massachusetts, Adam from Japan, and Squire from Kentucky. Now, I cannot believe we forgot Squire from Kentucky.
Oh, he's been donating forever.
When,
we were like, Kentucky? Do we even have anyone?
No, Ben said it, to be fair. Ben said it.
That's true. He didn't listen.
So,
listen
we apologize.
Either.
And also, thank you, Alyssa.
That means we have two viewers in Kentucky. I wonder if
yes.
they know each other.
Do you guys know each other? If not, you should
How big
meet.
Is Kentucky? All right, so that means we have three states taken care of. Two states.
Yes. And then we have whatever from, does last week count?
Yeah. It's the whole month.
Okay.
Was that this month? I don't know. We got a lot more states, though, to go. 47 more,
and
at least.
And we had an email from Jason in Canada. He wrote, hey guys and gal, don't forget about us Canucks. Curious how many watch and donate from up here. There was a lot of E's. I don't know if I put them in the right spot. I hope so.
Yeah, we got it.
So thank you for watching, Jason.
We get a lot of Canucks.
We just had a Canada.
They loved my comment way back in the early days about Canada being America's hat. Remember
they
that?
Did.
They loved that. It was hilarious.
I saw something
to
about Canada is the equivalent of Hufflepuff somewhere online.
Hey,
it was funnier when it was online. Anyway.
I like Hufflepuff. That's my favorite house.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
Ravenclaw.
Hufflepuff.
I like that neither of us chose a popular house. All right. Contest. We have one that just ended, the Dude Box Contest. We need to pick a winner from Sarah's box. Would you like to tell them what they're going to win?
They are going to win a Mo Money Bunny Dude Box by Mark Melling. Okay, ready?
I'm ready. Are you going to pick?
Yep.
Because I've been shaking it pretty good.
Because you've been shaking up her box.
Yeah, here it goes. Who's it gonna be?
There's a lot of them in there. Feels like
I
a
know.
Lot of them.
There was a lot of entries. Thank you to everybody who took the time to enter.
And the winner is Shadow Master.
Shadow Master. I think he was the first one to post.
Well, there you go. I
That's
guess it
funny.
Pays to be
I think,
early.
I think. Can we give a shout out to Novocaine31 because he had the best comment?
And his comment was?
Because the dude abides. For the dude box. Get
the dude,
dude
box abides.
If you haven't seen Big Lebowski, do yourself a favor and see it.
Yeah, there's somebody watching this show that hasn't seen Big Lebowski. I
Maybe
find that
there
hard
is.
To believe.
I don't know.
Shadow Master, PM me on the forum. I'm George Gaspar, PM me on the forum, and I will PM me your address, and I will send you out the dude box thing that you won.
Excellent.
By Mark Melling.
So what happens when one contest ends?
That means we start a new one, and I just happen to have this box here.
You could win that box. Yay!
with that logo on it right there. I don't want to put the address on there.
We can see our address. Our address is fine,
not theirs. You know what that logo means?
I didn't see it. What's the logo?
You know what that logo is for?
I do. It's for the surprise. No? Oh, am I wrong? Ooh, I got a fancy card. I got a fancy card.
So it's got a bunch of this on it. It must mean it's important.
This is from memakepretty.com. That's a great website, first of all.
I've never seen a custom wrapped in wax paper before, but okay.
Whatever works. Whatever you have lying around, use it.
Booyah.
Wow.
Carson Catlin was nice enough to create an 8-inch Key Bear custom.
Amazing custom.
In his cutout style. I don't know what you call this.
I think there is a name for it.
I saw it on Spanky's blog.
What would it be called?
Like reticulated or something like that? I don't remember. Some kind of crazy word. Whatever the word is. Look at that thing.
It's amazing.
You
can see through it. Can you see through
it? It's purple on the inside, green on the outside for our two favorite colors. You could see through it kind of on there. I don't know if you can. But
that's an amazing custom.
If you've never held one or seen one in person of his customs, I recommend doing it.
I think it's even more amazing in person. Because in pictures, you can't really see the 3D-ness and the cutoutness.
Yeah. So very cool. So thank you, Carson.
So to win this, you simply need to head over to the contest section on the Toy Break forum and submit your drawing of a bear. Your drawing. Not one that we can find on Google Images.
Right.
We can look at that, too.
Just draw a bear. Doesn't like bear. Whatever. Any
it
kind
could
of bear.
It be on a napkin. Any kind of bear. It could draw be a key bear paper.
If you want. I don't care.
Could do it in MS Paint. It doesn't matter. Just draw a bear.
Draw it with a pencil and take a picture with your phone. Post it.
That's cool.
Whatever you want to do.
Draw it in a phone app.
Sure.
Draw it on your friend's face while they're asleep.
Use Alex Pardee's Make Awesome. What's it called?
I can't remember.
Way Cooler. Download the Way Cooler app. Make a bear in that, even. I'll accept that.
All right. Well, the deadline for that contest is going to be October 17th. And don't forget, you can follow the creator of this amazing custom, Carson Catlin, at Carson Catlin on Twitter. And you can also check out some awesome customs that Carson is doing, custom dunnies.
Yes.
Which will be available from Tenacious Toys at New York Comic Con, booth 3121.
Booyah.
We haven't announced that we're going.
No, we haven't.
Hey, guys, if anybody's going to be at New York Comic Con, we're going to be there. Yay!
Yay! Toy Break invades New York Comic Con.
Or George and Aileen
Or we're just
going to
be walking around.
Maybe we need to do some sort of invasion. Like, we have a boombox, and there's songs playing, and we have bling.
We need someone to carry a boombox behind us.
Like, okay.
Up in the air, and then with some kind of invasion sounds.
Is it going to be playing, like, Say Anything? Like,
I think it's going to be playing, like, the Rocky theme.
In your eyes.
No, I think it's going to be like the Rocky theme.
Okay, that's better.
That's a little Eye of the Tiger as we run around.
All day long. It won't get old at all. It's going to be amazing. All
right, so go win. Follow at Carson Catlin and then win this awesome custom that comes wrapped in a million things, including wax paper.
The more stuff it's wrapped in, the awesomer it is. Right?
Yeah.
All right, on to news.
That's the last time you're going to see this in person, because I'm going to wrap it back up in that box after this. So get a good look at it now. Ready? Get a good look. Here we go. Maybe you can edit this in later in future episodes. Booyah.
All right, on to news.
Outsmart Originals.
Ooh, that sounds new.
Check out this teaser image for something exciting coming from Outsmart Originals and John Paul Kaiser, among other artists. Be sure to follow Outsmart Originals on Facebook.
Well, the teaser specifically.
Yes, the teaser has John Paul Kaiser's art. So check out Outsmart Originals on Facebook to keep up with all of their new stuff that's coming. It's a new company with new stuff.
We like Outsmart Originals, the people behind that, and we like John Paul Kaiser, so I'm excited about that.
And, I mean, there was a lot of artists tagged in that image.
Yeah.
So, like, if that means anything, we'll find out. I don't know.
All right.
Guys
Keep
like
an
Voltaire
eye.
Were in there.
Dudebox USA now open. USA.dudebox.com is now open for all of your Dudebox needs.
And if you didn't win, now you need to do box of your own.
You do.
So only
Fabergé Army
Shadow Master doesn't need to go there. Everyone else?
Only Shadow
Master. No excuse. Transforming Collections. 24-page full-color introduction to the world of unofficial Transformer toys and accessories. This is written, or photographed and written, I guess. Put together by Phil Reed from battlegrip.com.
So you know
and
it's quality.
You could support it on Kickstarter. Just go to Kickstarter and type in Transforming Collections or...
Or go to the link in the show notes on toybreak.com.
Even easier.
He doesn't watch the show.
Phil is putting together... He does... At Battle Grip, he does reviews of toys, and a lot of the things he reviews are knockoff, I guess not knockoff Transformers, but unofficial Transformers made by third-party companies.
Yeah, it's pretty fascinating.
I didn't really even know this whole world existed that much.
See, that's why you need the book.
So I supported it. We're on there. We're getting one.
And he has some stretch goals he's working towards, which is pretty exciting.
Yeah. You can get stickers and extra pages, bigger book, that kind of stuff.
There may be a hardcover version. That would be very cool.
Let's see how far we can take this.
Very exciting. We also have a voicemail.
Let's hear it.
Shall we?
Hey, George, Aileen, Ben, and or guest. This is Alexander Gwynn here. I see a lot of custom shows and art shows that usually have a theme, usually a lot of things to do with the 80s and such. I was wondering where to find out about kind of exhibitions that have a theme and where to submit, because I'd quite like to get involved in some and design some pieces and do all that good stuff. But the first time I ever hear about these exhibitions are when they're being announced, and by then it's too late to get involved. Do you know of anywhere where I can find out about this information, like websites? If so, much appreciated. Take care.
First off, Alexander Gwynn, amazing, awesome, thank you for calling, and don't forget you could go check out his Toy Break paper versions of us at toybreak.com on the goodies page.
Have we ever had a call by Alexander before?
I don't think so, have we?
I don't know, he sounds so much more grown up than I pictured.
What does that mean?
I don't know, what he would sound like.
What does that mean?
You don't, I don't know, it's cool to hear his voice. Like you
it
did
is
a paper
cool to
toy,
hear his
like
voice.
Now it's cool to hear. Put a voice to it.
Put a voice to it.
I guess my opinion on that would be find the galleries that are doing these shows that you enjoy.
Yes.
And then contact the galleries, and you can either, if you're local, you can bring in artwork and show them, or if you're
not local,
you might want to send them a link to your portfolio. But kind of hit up the galleries.
Yourself.
Yeah, introduce yourself to the galleries that you're interested in and say, hey,
I make customs. I'd love to be involved in your next group custom show.
Or I'm an artist. I do, this kind of art. If you have any group shows that are coming up, I'd love to do a piece. And if you like it, maybe we can put it in, kind of get it in that way. And then if your stuff gets in and it starts selling, then they're more than likely to bring you back. So
really contacting galleries is the absolute best way. Hearing from friends who are artists who are also in the gallery.
Right.
Somebody else may be in a custom show and they're like, oh, hey, you're in that? Do you mind if I get the contact information? And maybe I can contact them about being in it.
No.
And also, Spanky posts a lot on SpankyStokes.com about shows ahead of time. If the show is announced ahead of time, I see a lot of it go by on his blog.
Right. Now, I don't know if galleries want that. I'm not a gallery. I don't know if that, how galleries react to that kind of thing.
But here's the thing.
I would imagine they all want new, I would imagine they all want new artists, right? Eventually, one of these new artists is going to be the next big artist. So I would imagine that would be the right way to do it.
Other people stop making art and die, so there have to be new artists.
Exactly.
Right?
Sure. So
I don't mean that in a mean way. I just mean there has to be new people.
But this is a good question to put on the forum or in the comments on YouTube. How did you first start getting involved in group shows?
Good question. How did we start?
We just made a group show.
No, that's not true.
We hosted our own.
That's not true. We were on forum back in the day called Keister.
Oh, yeah.
And a lot of shows were organized around that because the designer toy community was much smaller.
Yeah.
So that was one of the, sort of central hubs to find people.
That's true. And we've done a couple of shows through our forum as well. Or not really, not shows in a gallery or anything, but we've done shows, through the forum for the forum. So that's a good way to start getting your name out that way as well. If your piece is awesome and people start spreading it around, other people will take notice.
And promote yourself. The more people see your name, the more they're going to remember it and go, oh, yeah, that guy, I remember. He's something. He's doing something. I need to invite him to my show.
And even though everybody complains about people doing the same thing over and over again, doing the same thing over and over again definitely helps cement who you are.
You mean an artist developing their style?
Right, yeah. Like Frank Kozik and a rabbit with a cigarette. Like, it's like, all right, enough already. We got it. But, like, that's
when you see it, you know it's a Frank Kozik.
Right, like, that's what helps build his brand bigger and bigger, so.
Ah, the Frank Kozik brand. All right, well, with that, I think it's time to move on to Blind Box. Do you guys know what time it is? Blind Box time! Blind Box time! What do we have today, George?
Lego minifigures.
Come on, this is exciting. Lego minifigures collectible series number 8.
So these were sent in by Billy Boy from the forum.
Thank you.
He, I guess, had some extras lying around. Wanted to send them in for us.
I want them all. Can I say that?
Yeah, you can. Hey, look what I have here.
Wait, you have to pick one. Stop.
I want the bat.
I want the guy with the bowler hat and the financial news newspaper. That one's hard to open. Thanks, Aunt Terry.
It has a picture of scissors cutting, so it must mean you have to cut it.
Well, if Lego says I need to do that, then I need to do it.
Well, I'm not mad at this one. I got a robot.
Robot's awesome. That's one of the, like, ones. Oh, I got a good one, too. That's one of the ones that people are going to, like, make armies of.
Really? Black robot?
Yeah, black robot. I think you mean African-American robot.
That's racist.
I got a red one.
I like that he has a cool red hand and a claw hand.
That's what you like about him?
Oh.
Have you seen a lot of
this? His laser gun has a laser beam.
Your laser gun has a laser beam. So.
Why does he have a big dumb helmet though? He looks cooler without it.
Alas, poor Yorick. Oh, I knew him well.
Is an actual skull printed? Oh, it is. Look at that.
Isn't that awesome? I got the little Shakespeare dude with the ruffled collar.
Look at his little Three Musketeers mustache.
And his concern on his face. This is good. I like the Van Fur style doublet that
That's
I can
cool,
use
yeah.
on other figures.
So look, what do you think? Helmet? Or no helmet?
I think he's got a really cool face.
Yeah, I think no helmet is better.
But you can get two and then display him each way. So we were sent several of these, so we're going to open up another set.
Let's do it.
Because more Lego, never a bad thing. Ah, that one worked.
Mine didn't.
Yes!
What'd you get?
The one I wanted.
Really?
I like to think of him as the guy from the Thomas Crown Affair, but he's a proper businessman.
I got the bat. Ah! We both got the one we wanted on the second poll. That's awesome.
Well,
thanks
I want
so much,
all,
Billy Boy. So.
Thank you, and good choices.
Oh, this is weird. He's not printed on the bottom. He has no leg print.
Oh, these smell really good.
Have they ever made arms like this before? Like, have they? I've never really seen other arms. That's weird.
Wow, that's great.
Like, this is a completely different position for the arm, even.
I can't think of.
If you were so inclined, you could cut off the wing and make it a Lego dude that's like, like running down the street. Like, I've never seen an arm in that position.
Yeah, that's pretty interesting, actually. I can't totally confirm that, but I don't think they have. Do you want to see my dude? He's awesome.
Wow, again, I think might be better without the head.
Without the head?
Like, no, like, that's
no,
just a cool
creature.
I like
the ears. The ears are cool. He's cute with the ears. He's got little bat ears.
That's awesome.
That's a great figure.
Really cool. I like his
Almost
little greaser bat hair. That's actually pretty good.
Look at his little purple tie. Reading the Financial Times.
He's on his way to...
steal things at the museum, Thomas Crown Affair.
I was going to say he looks like he's on his way to, like...
a Magritte painting?
The wizarding world. Like, he's going into, like... going into the flu network. He's going to get up in the thing.
I could just put the Quibbler, Daily Quibbler.
I think you should. He needs to have that newspaper in there.
Or should there be like a, this is not a pipe happening near him?
Oh, he looks surprised a little bit without his hat on. Oh,
he's shocked at the plummeting economic state
with his hat,
of the...
he looks a little bit more evil, like he's got something going down. And without his hat, he's surprised and concerned.
All right, well, I think this is one of the stronger series recently. 6 was kind of 7 was decent. I think there's a lot of good ones in here. And Santa, they finally got the hat right. There's a football player. We have some of the best ones right here. The bat. Look at the pirate face. Just look at the pirate face. That's just great.
Yeah. I think I got the only one I need. What's the record that that dude's got?
It's just a 2x2 round tile.
No, but he's got, like, I wonder what the album cover is.
I don't think you can read the words.
DJ Rugby? DJ Rugby? Hollywood Demons? Demos? Demos?
Divas? Dawas. Dawas. I can't read that.
That's cool. I don't know if there's any other ones I care about than the bat. Or maybe the pirate.
Also decided that the pretzel dude, you can use the face. It looks, in person, it looks better. It looks like Cary Elwes from like Men in Tights.
Oh, nice.
Or you could do your Princess Bride.
Princess Bride set.
Yeah.
Hey, UK people, if anybody has an extra boxer from the Olympics set, I want one. Just putting it out there.
There you go.
All right, what's up next?
Reviews!
Blood and Bolts. You want to talk about this while I open it up?
I will. This is by Garrett Luz. These are some customs he sent us. I think this is his second or third round of these sort of customs. He started taking them to conventions recently, and they will hopefully be available online soon at bloodandbolts.webs.com.
Okay.
So shall we check them out?
Yeah, let's do it. Looks like there's three here.
Well, there's usually three of us. Got here. These are heavy.
Oh.
These are way heavier than I thought they were going to be. Oh,
that one's cool.
That was mine. So we have three sizes here. A big fatty. A medium and a tiny. How cool are these? They feel kind of like those nesting dolls.
Yeah, this
but I think that's only because I see three sizes of them in front of me. I really like the way it looks like it's like cracking. It's like a very aged, weathered look.
Yeah, these are really cool. I don't even know what to say.
Are these wood?
I don't know. Like, are they resin?
I think they're wood. Look.
Yeah.
I did not know that. What are we smelling?
I'm just trying to see what they're... So what are they? Are they...
Mine looks like a skull, so I'm going to call mine...
Skullbot.
Skullbot.
Are they sculpted on top of wood? Are they carved in wood? What is the... How do you get that texture on the cracks and stuff? Like...
These are all good questions for Garrett.
These are cool.
He needs to put these online.
Can you buy these?
Hopefully soon.
Yeah.
Bloodandbolts.webs.com.
Okay. I'm now going to be part of monster.com, monster-con.com this year.
That's a convention.
I wonder if we missed that.
So another thing I like about this is the big gash across his face that's been patched up on top. Like bolted back together, like on a human, like on an organic thing, it would be stitched, but because he's like a robot-y thing, it's like bolted together.
Let's see this one.
Kind of Frankenstein-y. I really don't know if this is coming across in pictures, but the texture is what really sets these apart from other things. I really like these customs.
Oh, they're really cool. I kind of don't really know what to say. Like, this is... I haven't really seen anything like this. It's kind of a really neat thing.
These are kind of totally different from each other, too. Like, this one is like a cool little skull dude.
This one's kind of a mix of the two. Like, that's almost all robot.
This one's very robot-y.
This one's skull, and this one's kind of mixed of the organic and robot. Like, I don't know. This is such a weird... What a weird thing. Like,
they're kind of battle damaged. They're all kind of battle damaged. They're really nicely done. It's hard to describe what it is because it's not something that you've seen before. Are you having a staring competition with it?
No,
it's going to win.
Really like it. I'm down with this. I don't have any idea what it is or how to describe it, or what it was like made out of.
I'm going with wood. Definitely wood.
Yeah, I mean, it sounds like wood, and it has that weird thing. I wonder, does he turn his own wood? Where does he get these pegs? Like,
these are things we should ask
him. I want to know all this stuff.
Send us a video, Gary.
You should make a making of video or something and send it in. I would love to see, I would love to see an unpainted one to see what it looked like.
Oh, how did you start? Like a picture of, like, where did it start?
Because I know, like, all those little, all the little cracks are done.
Oh, and he's got a spine in the painting. Going down the back. I didn't mention that. Like a little.
But like the big carved stuff, like is it just carved out of a wood block?
Oh, boom. Stackable. Hey, that's a feature on some products.
Is it three stackable?
No. I don't want it to fall down and be sad.
These are rad.
Yeah, these are really cool. They're just
thanks for sending these in.
Really well done and very original and unique. And you can make funny little noises.
I'm cool. Down.
Well, thank you, Garrick. And again, thank you, Garrett. And again, bloodandbolts.webs.com. Watch that. And hopefully he will have some up for sale and some more pictures.
Dude, put these up for sale if you're not. I mean, maybe
he's
they are already.
It.
But
he's
dude,
working on it.
Work on it more.
On it more. What else do we have?
How about the Bonsai Dragon?
Bonsai.
This is the box.
Hey, that looks like it might be from Patch Together.
Oh, but look at this.
Picture. What's in the box? Bonsai Dragon.
Awesome. So yeah,
it's like a weird like 70s kung fu package.
It is. It's crazy. so it's Patched Together, like we said, by Poly Soup. Is that the name?
Poly Soup and Patched Together.
So there's the illustration on the front. I went ahead and preloaded this one. I took it out of the box because, as you know from Patched Together, they have the styrofoam inserts,
mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And this one was particularly messy.
So we didn't get.
So I didn't want to get
snowy particles.
Snow polyfoam everywhere.
All over
so
everything. So this unique collectible is available in four versions. There is spring, which is pink, summer, which is green, fall, which is yellow, and winter, which is silver. We have the green summer edition here. And this is it's patched together, so you might have guessed it's a resin piece.
They do more than resin, but they do a lot of resin.
They do mostly resin. They also do large sharks.
I don't know that I'm going to be able to, if this is going to be able to stay without me
gluing
it. But let's give it a shot. Let's see what.
So if you are like me and you don't have much of a green thumb and plants don't tend to stay alive, you could get this bonsai tree, which you do not have to water or care for. It just takes care of itself. Yay!
I gotta say, we've reviewed and talked about a lot of patched together things on this show in the past, and I think this might be the best thing that they've done. I really like that weed chick. It was like
yes.
The broccoli headed.
Do you like it because it looks like that?
Has the same
or this because it looks like that?
Has the same look to it as that broccoli girl. But man, what a cool sculpture. I'm a fan of tree things anyway, like, you know that,
right.
But just the mixture of the dragon and the tree, really nice.
And it just really flows, it really works together, there's nothing really forced.
Yeah. You know what would be cool is to get a little of that little mossy green, like, stuff, the little grass that goes in the bottom of bonsais, that little mossy stuff, and put it in
here.
They
put fake moss in bonsais?
No, like that little ground stuff. You can.
I think you should buy... If you wanted to put moss in here, get the kind that you use for, like, model trains.
Hmm. Oh, I have some.
Look how happy
I'm going to put that in there. It's so, like, this is such a nice thing.
This piece is $150.
Okay.
It's a really nice piece. I don't know if it's $150, honestly.
You just told me it was.
No, but, like, I don't know if it's worth, at least to me, $150.
See? More stuff.
It's a really beautiful piece, though. Like, this could go out in, like, an adult home that's not regularly filled with toys.
I think so.
You know what I mean?
Yeah. This crosses borders.
This would look really nice in, like, your boss's office sitting on their desk.
Well, you're my boss, so what do you think?
Give it to me. I'll put it on my desk.
So, yeah, I'm going to glue these pieces on before we go transport it around.
Yes.
And I'll put some little moss in there.
I don't know what else to say about it, because it's just got a great... look, so it look, you know, it looks tree-ish. It looks like,
yeah, I mean,
it's a representation
as far as like
of bonsai, but the sculpt
is,
of the dragon.
I mean, feel it. It's a heavy.
No, I'm not gonna.
It's
do
a
that.
Heavy resin piece. Like it's worth. I think it's worth the money. This
yeah.
Is, yeah.
And, like, the way the dragon head's, like, streaming back.
Mm-hmm.
Like, the tree is growing backwards, though. Like,
plus, it's probably probably pretty limited. I mean, do we know how many?
No.
Yeah. So, I'm guessing it's probably pretty limited. So, the price is probably right. I like it. I think it's a pretty nice piece.
I think it's a beautiful piece. Best paperweight holder ever.
You know what would make it just one step up is maybe put little pads instead of those, just the thing. Those little felt pads on the bottom. You
could probably buy your own.
I know, but it would bring it up to like, just it would cost a couple cents to add in the box and it would bring up the value.
Well, it's a beautiful piece. And yeah. I think it was good. It looked good in the pictures. It looks better in person.
It's really nice.
All right. What else? How big is this?
I don't know. This
That's
big.
It's probably like 9 inches, 10 inches in the pot.
It's heavy. I gotta put it down.
How about Draego-Man?
I got that right here.
Am I saying that right? Is it Draego-Man?
Draego-Man? Draego. Draego, right? I think it's Draego-Man.
I'm gonna call it Draego-Man.
Evil fire-breathing menace. This is a...
Me or Draego-Man?
Draego-Man.
Oh, okay.
This is a He-Man, Master of the Universe, 30th anniversary
from Mattel. 30th anniversary. So glad we signed up for that line.
You sound like you're not.
It's been like half awesome and half not so awesome.
Okay, well, this is the half that's awesome.
This is the awesome half.
Look at the size of this figure in the package. Like, first off, it's just like it's exploding inside. It's like filling the package.
Doesn't that make you feel like you're getting more for your money?
It does. I pre-cut that open. And thank look you. At this. So there's.
So this is, of course, from Mattel and the Four Horsemen. And this particular figure was designed by the Four Horsemen.
Yes. They were able to...
They design all the figures, but
this was designed. They don't design every figure. They're just redesigning some figures.
They didn't come up with She-Ra. They just redesigned her.
Right. So this one is fully designed and created by them.
That thing is strapped in there.
Yeah. Well, he's big. He could cut everything.
Look at that tail. Get him out. I need to see that tail. Hey, we had two dragons on this episode. That's cool.
Oh, yeah.
Whoa.
All right, and a tail.
The tail comes separate. It's so awesome.
So he's got almost like, was it Clawful that had that big tail like this? Maybe he's reusing that part. Man, he's huge.
There's a lot of texture on these wings. I like that.
Now that's how you design a He-Man guy. Like this just, like, there's been a few, if you follow us on the, if you're on our forum, you may have heard me complain a few times about some of the characters that are coming out in this line. That they don't, like, they're designed, basically they're designed by people now, but they were designed when those people were like six. So they didn't really have a design aesthetic or any talent. One of them's like a famous comic book dude, and like, dude, you picked a dude from when you were like six and you draw superheroes, so sorry, it doesn't fit in He-Man world. This fits perfectly in the realm of He-Man.
Look at that.
It has the armor with the chest with the symbol on it, like the right, like it's not just like a hi, I'm a heart. It's like it's got the cool dragon.
You mean the spade?
Yeah, I meant spade, but I was making fun of it. So, like, it just, this fits perfectly in the line. He's got the loincloth, he's got the boots, like, it just looks like a He-Man character that could have been made back in, like, the cartoon days.
Not only that, but the coloring helps, too.
Yeah.
Like, this looks like it came straight out of the cartoon. Like, these colors would be
cartoon in the colors. Cartoon. Yeah. It's not just,
I'm
like...
I'm sure about the flaming sword, although I would have liked to see something like that animated. His hands, they look really cool.
It's awesome.
Oh, he's got three fingers. That'd be hard to grip things.
So this is the way you design a new He-Man character.
Look at that face. It's awesome.
The sculpting's just incredible.
Look how proud he is.
Look what happens when you can do what you want to do. You know?
You
like when you're like,
you
here, go ahead and sculpt it to be as cool as you want it to be.
I like the variation of paint all over it. On the back of the wings, there's, you know, darker spots. Kind of maybe almost burnt colored. Then there's not just flat purple and red everywhere, but there's this sort of metallic blue accents on the armor, which is a really nice touch. And I do like this flaming sword.
What happened? Like 2 seconds ago, you didn't.
No, I like the idea of the flaming sword. Like,
I love all that detail in the face. Like, all the,
I don't know, something. I think it's growing on me.
That's good. So awesome. We just want to, we don't do all of the He-Man reviews on here because we get a figure a month, but you know.
And Pixel Dan does a very good job of that already over at He-Man.org, and we cannot possibly compare to that. So, yeah. Plus so watch some, his videos.
Get some early. Ours is months late. Whatever.
It's still a cool toy, and you can probably pick it up on the secondary market if you're still interested.
Yeah, I would definitely recommend it, even if you're just into dragon figures.
Look at the tail. Look how big that is.
It's rad.
And the tail, it gives him a third point to stand on. No issues. Not going to fall over.
Especially because it's using the old feet that have the tiny little ankles. Ugh. Mattel. Ugh.
I want to see an animation with this guy in it.
Yeah, it'd be rad.
Make that happen.
Maybe he'll make into the comic books or something.
I wish you could, like, his horns are really weird and flexible. Like,
they'll probably go back to be to their real regular shape. They've been smushed in the box for a while.
But I wish they had, like, a little wire in there so I could make him, like, I'm a sad Draego-Man. Oh. Or then he's like, rah, I'm angry. Or like,
should we move on?
Well, that's actually about it for our reviews.
Okay.
Would you like to move on to events?
Let's do it.
Up first, Vinyl Thoughts, Toy and Art Show at Life in Deep Element in Dallas, Texas, September 13th. It's a one day, one evening show. VinylThoughtsArtShow.com.
One day, huh?
One day.
Wow. Get out.
Just like decon.
I wonder if it's buy it and take it kind of thing.
Probably.
I like that.
I think it's like almost in a way decon. Like it's not just art show. It's
okay.
It's sort of a little con thing.
Oh, nice.
Like there's events.
Speaking of a con.
There may be food trucks. I'm not sure.
Kamikaze.
Never.
Comic, anime, gaming, sci-fi, fantasy, and horror expo at the Los Angeles Convention Center. In Los Angeles, California. September 15th and 16th, it's kamikazeexpo.com.
And we will be there on Saturday.
Wandering
most likely
the floor.
Wandering around, invading, as it were.
Ben behind us with a boombox playing.
And a trench coat.
Whatever he's going to play this time.
I get to say this one. Great. Tokusatsu?
Sure.
Japanese science fiction group art show featuring over 100 artists at Q-Pop Shop and Mini Gallery in Los Angeles, California, September 15th to October 14th, qpopshop.com.
El Paso Comic Con.
Where's that?
The Sun City. The Sun City's pop culture and mainstream media event at El Paso Convention Center in El Paso, Texas, September 14th to the 16th, and special guest Shane Ditsworth and Owen O-Dog Ortling. How do you say that last name?
Ortling.
Ortling from the Four Horses Studios. Just call him O-Dog. Will be in attendance and present a panel. You get to check out ep-con.com.
I heard that Shane and O-Dog love hugs.
I heard they love hugging each other.
I heard that, but they also like strangers to hug them.
They do. So hug them if you're there.
They like hugs a lot. Like, and remember, it doesn't qualify as a hug unless it lasts 10 seconds or longer.
And there's a hand on the butt.
Yes. Finally, PowerCon, He-Man, She-Ra, and Thundercats fan convention at the Torrance Marriott South Bay in Torrance, California, September 22nd and 23rd, thepower-con.com. Yet again, we will be there.
Lock your car doors.
Lock your car
doors. I'm just saying, you're in Torrance.
Wow. Wow, really?
No offense, Torrance. Hey, we don't get any donations from Torrance.
Let us know, even if you don't donate, just if you're in Torrance, shoot us an email or send us a tweet or something. I want to know.
If there's any Torrance viewers?
I know one person in Torrance. I don't know if he watches, though.
Me too.
Oh, do you?
Mm-hmm.
Well, then.
Let's wrap it up.
Let's. That's the end of episode 231. Don't forget, you can save money at places. Oh, I'm going to put these back here so you can look at them some more while I talk. Don't forget, you save money all around the web with coupons. You can find those coupon codes in the show notes at toybreak.com, along with links to everything we talk about in the episode. You can watch past episodes, you can download episodes, you can join the contests and the discussions in the forum, you can download goodies like paper toys, three different versions of us from three different artists, including voicemail, famous voicemail caller, Alexander Gwynn, Zakane, and Castlefort. You can also help out the show, huge, huge help, if you go to toybreak.com, over on the left-hand side, click the Amazon link, then just do your shopping as normal. We get a little help from Amazon. It's pretty awesome. We really appreciate it. You can also call, just like said famous Alexander Gwynn, leave us a voicemail at 818-AM-I-GOOD. You can email us, info@toybreak.com. You can keep up with us on Facebook at facebook.com/toybreak. You can watch our toy briefs and full episodes at youtube.com/toybreak. You can follow us on Twitter. I am at Aileen Gaspar.
At George Gaspar.
I am also that on Instagram.
Me too.
You're at Aileen Gaspar on Instagram? That's going to get confusing.
I post a lot of pictures of food. What was I gonna say? Forget it.
Good job.
Oh, do you have an event coming up, toy related, that you want us to talk about? Email it to us, info@toybreak.com.
Hey, that's a great idea.
Just saying.
And we also have a really cool thing up on YouTube that you just did.
We do?
We do.
What is it?
Well, we get asked many a time, since we've started the show, we've been asked many times about making your own toys, and one of the things we recommend to people is to make a pressure pot on the cheap. And what does a pressure pot do?
It pressurizes your silicone for when you're making molds, or it pressurizes your resin for when you're pouring castings to eliminate air bubbles in both situations.
And it won't get rid of 100%, but it's going to get rid of like 90%.
It helps. It's better to do it than to not use it, especially in the silicone part.
And if you're serious about, you know, moving up from, maybe you've tried casting a few resin figures and you're ready to make many more resin figures, we made a video on how to put together a pressure pot.
You can also use an evacuator, but we didn't show how to make that.
But we put together, thank you for that information. But so we have a video up on YouTube right now. We'll actually show you a clip from it in just a minute. But it's how to make a pressure pot for under $200.
Nice.
Well, at least $200 US. I don't know where to get stuff in other countries.
True. You're on your own.
Anyway, thank you so much and enjoy the video. We will see you next week.
We are going to show you how to build... how to convert a paint pot into a pressure pot for all of your molding and casting needs. Your pressure gauge is one of the first things you're going to put on. Now, what's going to happen though, is everything's going to escape here and here. So we need to close those two as well. And this stuff is all kind of like nicely laid out for you when you get it. This is the safety valve. You'll put this on like this. Crank the lids tight. And then let the air in. Here you can see it's full of air right now, so